a lot of years in hospitals for children with my oldest son. And I always have to say first that my son is okay, so people don't get too sad. I remember those places as full of kids, very sick, sometimes dying, who were funny and flirting and having parties and being teenagers, being loud and foul-mouthed and irreverent and fun. And I wanted my book to kind of honor that spirit of those kids that I had known. I did not know my grandmother, but I'm sure she would not have been like Richie's grandmother. And probably because of my age and my time of life, I was imagining someone that would be almost fun to be, someone who comes from where I come from, the state of New Jersey in the United States. A Jersey girl is supposed to be kind of tough and a fighter, and she's been poor her whole life, but she is also full of spirit and life. She was a very fun character to write. I didn't write it for young adults. I had published three books earlier, and one was a short story called Soothy Syndrome, which was a version of this novel, a short version. And when I decided to expand it, I just decided I'd make it into a novel. Didn't really have any thought about whether it would be young adult or anything else, but when I sent it to my agent, she said, I think this is young adult, and let's try sending it to a variety of publishers, some for adult, some for young adult. And the adult publishers wrote back and said, we like this book very much, but it's young adult. So it came out with Algonquin Young Readers as their one of their first young adult novels. And I was very pleased with what they did with it. I liked their marketing, I liked what they did. So I was happy to be in the young adult field, but didn't try to do that. I think the young adult readers that I hope for are a little bit older than a young teenager, so maybe 16, 17 years old. They're smart, they're very aware of the world. I do think they may read it a little differently than adult readers. Lots of adult readers also read the book. But the young adult readers often read it more for the love story angle. The adult readers often get a little more out of the adult characters. They might understand a character like Sylvie's father better. Young adult readers think of him really as a monster. And adult readers see that he is in pain. He is in terrible pain and he acts badly. He drinks way too much, but he's human. And he's vulnerable. So there's been different reactions, but I love the reactions of the young readers. I love to get their letters. I've gotten letters from high school students asking me to help them fill out their worksheets on the book. And I said I won't do their homework for them, but they have good questions. I have just read Margaret Atwood's trilogy, Oryx and Crake. I don't usually read fantasy. I loved it so much. I got one book, I got the next book, I got the next book. I can't imagine any young reader or adult that couldn't get pulled up into her world because it's Margaret Atwood and she knows what she's doing. She's such a good writer. So I loved that book.